Hello friend, I am Naval. You are watching Code with Naval. Welcome to Java series part 5. In this video, we will write our first program with using a notepad, and as well as we will download Eclipse and let's set up Eclipse and how can we write our first program in Eclipse. Let's see in this video. Let's first download Eclipse. I'll simply copy this URL and I'll simply go on this page. You can see here we have an option. The first option is the Eclipse IDE for Java Enterprise Edition downloaders. Here I am using a Oxygen 3rd version because it's a support everything and it's a lightweight. This Oxygen version work on any environment or any system. Here we have an option: Windows 32/64, Mac 32/64 and Linux 32/64. Depend on your operating system, you can download any version. So my OS is a Windows 64. Simply I click this Windows 64. Okay, when I click this Windows 64, then I got here new page. Here we have an option: download button. Simply click on that download button and it start downloading. You can see here it's around 334 MB. I have already this downloaded, that's why I'll simply pause this download. Okay, I'll show you where once this download you will get this zip file. Okay, RAR zip file. You have to simply unzip that, or we can say extract that file. Then you get this folder. Okay, inside this folder there another folder, Eclipse folder. Inside a Eclipse folder there have a Eclipse application file. Okay, this Eclipse application file, if you want that Eclipse application file in your start menu or your taskbar, then here option pin to start, pin to taskbar. Here we have an option already. We simply click here and open that Eclipse. Here we got an option, we can create a new workspace. For that I'll simply create a one new folder, new workspace folder in a Java tutorial. Here I'll create a workspace folder and I'll simply select here that folder, browse that folder. Okay, simply in a e drive we have a Navalchen YouTube. Okay, in that we have a my video folder, in that we have a Java tutorial folder, in that we have a workspace folder. I'll simply that workspace folder and select OK. And here we have a button launch. Okay, we simply launch Eclipse Oxygen 3. You can see here our Eclipse is launched. Here we got a welcome page. In a welcome page, Eclipse provides some guideline or some features. Okay, we can say we simply close this welcome page and we have to create our project. We have to create our Java project. Simply file new, and here we have many option: Maven project, dynamic web project, enterprise application project. In this tutorial we are going to simply work on a core Java. That's why here we have a option project. Okay, simple project, and here we have a Java project. I'll simply click on that Java project and hit the next button. Here we can give project name. I'll simply give Code with Naval. Okay, here we have an option which JRE we want to select. Everything we can select here. Okay, let's write a project name and hit the next button and then hit finish button. Okay, open perspective. Okay, let's hit the finish button. Let's minimize this task list because we don't need this right now. Outline, let's minimize this outline as well. Now you can see here our project is created. Here we got a two file. One is a jar library. Here all required a jar present. We can add, if you want to add any external jar, we can add those jar here. And the second folder is the SRC folder. Inside SRC folder there is a nothing. Okay, whatever program, whatever class we write, first we have to create a package, because it's good to organize our code. Okay, here we simply create a package. I'll give a package name demo and hit the finish button. Inside a demo we can create a class. Inside this demo I'll simply create a class, and class name is a test. Here we got a option which modifier I have to select. We can't create a class as a private and protected. Okay, that's why those are unclickable. Okay, but we can select a public package. Okay, abstract class, we can create an abstract class, we can create a final class. That's why those are clickable. Okay, and if we see here, in every class super class is a object class. You can see here super class java.lang.object class. If we want to inherit any inheritance, then we can simply inherit from here also. We can simply add and we can simply type those inheritance. Okay, and we can inherit those inheritance from during the class creation. Also we have an option here which method we have to create. We have to create a public static void main or constructor or super class, which we have to create. I'll keep as it is all this, because we don't need anything from this. Okay, let's hit the finish button. You can see we got our class here. In a start execution we have a main method. Every execution start from main method. That's why first we have to write here main method. We will discuss everything about the main method. Okay, in a here Eclipse we have some shortcut features. We will discuss on that, about that also. Simply if I type here main and control space, okay, you can see here we got this method public static void main. Okay, simply hit the enter button, you can get that main method. Inside a main method I want to write a system.out.println. okay, I'll simply type here syso and control space. You can see here you got here system.out.println. We will discuss everything about this, you don't worry. Okay, I'll simply give the overview what we are going to discuss in upcoming videos. Okay, simply here we type a hello world and save. And if you don't know, I'll mention Eclipse is a runtime compile. If I done any mistake here, Eclipse immediately throw the error, because whatever I change code, it's immediately compile and it's immediately throw error. Okay, when we writing a code, only that time we are getting a error if anything missing or anything we write wrong. Okay, let's save this and run this program. I'll simply right click that file, and here we have option run as a server and run as a Java application. This project is not a web project, that's why it's not running on a server. It's a standalone application, that's why it's run on a Java application. I'll simply click this Java application, and you can see we got here our first program result, hello world. Now it's part of Eclipse, but what if someone ask you, without Eclipse can you do this in a notepad? Yes, we can do that. If any interviewer ask you and they don't provide any editor, we will simply create one file. I'll show you. Okay, I'll simply create, okay, let's Java program. Here you can see I'll delete this. Okay, here we will simply create one text file. Okay, text file, I'll simply give a test name, and in a Eclipse I'll copy this class test class, control C, and I'll paste this all code inside this file, control V. Now we have to save this file as a Java file. save as test test dot java and select here text instead of text document any file and hit the save button and close this file. You can see here we got test file. Delete this text document. Here we got Java file. Now we have to compile and execute this file. So how can we do that without using Eclipse? So simply we have to run cmd. So how can we run in this location directly cmd? We can simply select this path. Okay, simply click there and type cmd. Okay, cmd and hit the enter button and your cmd prompt open on that location. Now we have a command, few commands for a compile. We have a java c, java compile. C means compile. And then we have to pass that file name. Our file name is a test test dot java. Our file name is a test dot java. You can see here test test. Okay, it's my bad. Test test dot java and hit the enter. You can see here we got Java C is not recognized as an internal or external command. So how can we fix this issue? Okay, I will show you. Simply open environment variable, edit and edit the system environment variable. Okay. Open this. Here we have an option environment variable. Click this. Now here we have a path. In the system variable, you can see here we have a path. Open this, click, simply double click. And here you can see C program file Java JDK. Okay, here we need a till the bin. Okay, so how can, here we have to add a two more URL, or we can say path. So how can we do that? I'll simply open my C folder, my Java installed folder. In a C folder, there we have a program file folder. In a program file folder, there we have a Java folder. In a Java folder, you can see here we have a JDK and JRE. I'll simply open JDK and bin and copy this URL. Simply copy this URL and add this URL here. Simply create a new and add and OK. And one more URL we have to add. Here we add a JDK. Now we have to add JRE. Okay, simply open that JRE. Okay, JRE bin and copy this as well. Copy this and paste new, add this and select OK. OK. And close this. OK. Okay. Now we have to relaunch this CMD. I'll simply close this CMD and I'll again open in that particular location this program file. Simply click here and type here cmd and hit the enter button. And now we have to compile our test file. Okay, test file. For that, which command we use? We use a java compile. Java c means java compile and that particular file name. File name is a test 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 dot test dot java. Okay, let's verify test dot java, test dot java. Let's hit the enter button. You can see in this time we didn't get any error. Okay, how can we resolve, how we resolve that error? We simply add those two path in a environment variable. Then we have to run this program. For running this file, let's check first. You can see when we compile this program, then we got here test.class file. If we open this file, okay, I'll simply open this file in a notepad. You can see we got code something like this. This is a byte code. We can't change this code because we don't understand this code. That's why people say Java is secure. Okay, let's close this. Now we have to run this program. Initially we compiled that program and we got test.class file. Now we have to run program. For running program, we have a command java and simply file name. फाइल नेम इज द टेस्ट टेस्ट जावा टेस्ट एंड हिट द इंटर बटन. यू कैन सी हियर वी गॉट हेलो वर्ड आउटपुट. ओके, इन दिस वे वी कैन कंपाइल, वी कैन राइट, वी कैन कंपाइल और एग्जीक्यूट प्रोग्राम यूजिंग अ कमांड. ओके, बी केयरफुल, यू हैव टू फर्स्ट एड दोस बीन, वी कैन से एड दोस इन्वायरमेंट वेरिएबल इन योर एडिट इन्वायरमेंट वेरिएबल JDK and JRE, then you can only perform this. Otherwise, it's give a Java C not recognize internal or external command. So in this video, we saw how can we download Eclipse, how can we write, how can we create a project in Eclipse, and we execute first program in a Eclipse as well as we execute a first program with using a command line prompt. So let's see next topic in a next video. Till that, bye bye.